Welcome to Oyate Today. Oyate in Lakota means people. Oyate Today is sponsored by Security First Bank, your financial partner since 1898. Security First Bank, a relationship you can count on. Member FDIC. Hi, welcome to Oyate Today. I am your host, Richie Richards. Oyate Today is produced by Tim and Jackie Gallego. Tim is an enrolled member of the Oglala Sioux Tribe. Our guests tonight are Maurice Twiss and Terry Jo Gibbons of the Lakota Nation Educational Conference held here in Rapid City, South Dakota. And thank you both for being here tonight.
Thank you for having
us. Thank you, Richie.
I'm excited. This is the 39th year of the Lakota Nation Educational Conference, and I'm excited to have this discussion tonight. So thank you both for being here. Okay. Maurice, could you tell us a little bit about yourself, sir, please?
Yes. My name is Maurice Twiss. I'm Oglala Sioux. I grew up on Cooney Table on the Pine Ridge Reservation, lived there most of my young life, went to school in the elementary schools in the reservation. I went to high school at Pine Ridge and finished at Interior, South Dakota. Mm-hmm. I went on to college at Chattern State College in Chattern, Nebraska, and received a degree in business education. I began a career of education at Ulrich, South Dakota, being the business teacher and the coach for 2 years. Went to Hemingford, Nebraska for a year, and then to Glendale, Wyoming to do coaching chores and teach business education. From there, I went back to higher ed into grad school at the University of South Dakota and finished grad school there.
Cool, awesome. And Terry Jo, could you tell us a little bit about yourself as well?
Sure. I grew up in Gordon, Nebraska, actually 10 miles north on the South Dakota border on my folks' ranch. And I started a family right after high school. And when my boys got old enough to go to school, then I went back to college and I graduated with a BS in education from Oglala Lakota College. And I was part of the bilingual teacher trainee program through Shannon County School District that Maurice actually started. Mm. And so I went to work at Shannon County after I got my degree, and I worked there about 5 years before going on to SDSU to finish my master's in elementary education. And I continued to work at Shannon County School District until about 2 years ago when I retired.
So you're both retired then?
Yes, we are.
That's good. It's a good place to be.
Yes, it is.
Maurice, you have a very impressive resume, and I know that we could discuss that through the whole show, but let's talk about the conference here. Let's talk about the Lakota Nation Educational Conference. How did this begin and when did this begin, sir?
Well, it certainly is a part of our lives, and we've had it for, this will be the 39th consecutive year that it existed. It began 1979, several of us were just discussing the fact that we didn't have an adequate place to have a focus on Native American education. So we decided, I think there was a Marvin Amiot who was a tribal attorney, his brother Lowell Amiot, Ray Howe, and some others that decided we needed to put on a conference that addressed some things, some legal entities that people needed to address the state or the federal government with, and that we could be a legal arm of the law to present these things. And other things about curriculum, et cetera, that we thought the natives were not getting an equal opportunity. So we met and began an organization, our conference we called the Federal Programs and in Education Conference. And that started in 1979. And it ran almost simultaneously with the Lakota Nation Invitational activities, basketball at that time. So we ran them both. I think the Invitational was down at Pine Ridge for 2 years, and then it moved to Rapid City. But we had already started the education portion of that, and it was held at the old Imperial 400 down on St. Joe Street.
St. Joe, yep.
And it was always interesting that at that time, you know, we had 40 people perhaps in attendance, but it was still back in the old smoking days, and they put us in the basement, and the smoke was above the people's head, and the presenter was on stage, and he couldn't see the audience. So we graduated up toward, and where it currently is, I think it was the Holiday, no, the
Howard,
yeah. Howard Johnson's.
The old Hojo's up there on La Crosse. Yeah,
yeah. On La Crosse. And it's actually been there since. They changed their name, of course, that's where we still have it.
And so it's being held at the Ram Coda this year then. What are the dates for this then, for this year's event?
It starts on December 12th, Wednesday through Saturday.
Oh, cool. So the 12th, 13th, 14th, and 15th. Awesome. Terry Jo, could you tell us what is the intentions of this conference then? What are the intentions for, say, in the past and up to the present then?
Well, in the past, the intentions have changed a little bit from then till now, but basically is to provide information to educators and interested parties, parents, on the education of their students, whether they be native or non-native. With education, it's very trendy and things change and needs change. Mm-hmm. And as those needs change, then our presentations change. Mm-hmm. We try to follow what's needed, and we get that information from different schools and from the health people, from a lot of different places. We try to focus more on the whole child now than just the educational piece of their needs, because there are so many needs for the whole child. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of like when you go to Walmart, you go in there and you have a specific thing that you need, and so you go get it. Even though there's so many items that you could buy, you choose what you need and you leave. Mm-hmm. Well, that's where our conference is. We have a lot of we have 180 different presentations going throughout the conference.
Okay.
And whatever you need, I hope we have. Mm-hmm. And if we don't have it, you let us know so we can offer it the following year. Mm-hmm. That's what we try to offer, just what is needed for students.
So it's almost as culture changes, as society changes, then educational needs changes with that then.
Absolutely.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Maurice, the conference is held up here at the Ram Coda Inn. Is everybody invited to this then? Who should be attending this? Who can attend this? I know you had mentioned parents and teachers, but who should be attending this?
Well, originally we thought it was just for educators. However, you know, going through the change, it's really interesting. Everybody should be involved that can go, you know, in terms of parents. Mm-hmm. At one time we had students, and then we didn't have enough room to continue that strand. So we don't have, at this time, students involved in the conference, although some, you know, we would like to have some come. Mm-hmm. But teachers, educators, administrators, you know, all facets of the education program should certainly have something there that they need. Mm-hmm. So we're trying to hit the whole child and the whole educational gamut of people that we can address.
And so what organizations support this conference then?
Well, we have a lot of, and trying to, you know, just thinking about who are they, I guess I look at the entire program since 1979 and who supported it. That has really changed a lot, you know, different organizations, different entities. But the staple ones, you know, we received direction a lot from the Department of Education in Washington. You know, they assisted us some years and some years they didn't. Mm-hmm. And they would want to present how to do something or what to do, and so we would bring it down to Native country and present it. But also with that, you know, the NEI, National Indian Education Association, has been with us all the time on subject matter or content matter. And sometimes their president will be, here and sometimes not. I think Chris Bordo is on the board and he'll be representing him this year. But individually, you know, we've had people in town here, Darla Drew, a friend, and those people that help us, we consider very much friends, you know. Darla's been tremendous in helping us for arrangements and talking with different people. And a lot of those kind of, there's been people with us, one particular from Washington, D.C., his name is John Forkenbrock, who was the executive director of the NAFIS, the National Association for Federally Impacted Schools, for 39 years, ironically. And he came from the very first one. He missed one during the entire life of this conference.
Wow.
And that's, he attended 38 years. This year, he promised would be his last, so we're having him back. But looking at why is that important, I think he generated millions and millions of dollars for the schools of South Dakota and mostly Native American schools and Ellsworth, Douglas. So, you know, he's a tremendous person, and he'll be on the panel of educators this year.
That's awesome. Let's take a break, but I want to hear a little bit more about what's going to be happening at this conference. Give us some information on the presentations and the presenters, and we'll be back after a word from our sponsors.
You can't predict life's ups and downs. You just give it all you've got to stay on top. But it's easier with a partner like Security First Bank. Since 1898, we've been riding with you through the country's biggest ups and downs. And this is where we'll stay. Security First Bank, a relationship you can count on. Member FDIC.
It's really busy in the coffee house, not just in the morning, but all day long. And it's really important that we serve our customers hot coffee, coffee that's ready for them when they're ready for it.
We get that, Michelle. And our team at Black Hills Energy will make sure you have the electricity you need to keep that Java nice and hot. Speaking of hot Java, how about a cup for the road? Black Hills Energy. Life sponsored by Energy.
Native Sun News has been voted the best weekly newspaper in its class for 2015 by the South Dakota and North Dakota Newspaper Associations. You can find a copy of the Native Sun News at many businesses and vending machines in Rapid City and the surrounding area, and on all 9 reservations. We publish every Wednesday so advertisers and subscribers can reach our diverse readership by calling 605-721-1266. The Native Sun News covers the other side of the story.
Hi, welcome back to Oyate Today. Once again, our guests tonight are Maurice Twiss and Terry Joe Gibbons of the Lakota Nation Educational Conference, happening this week in Rapid City at the Ramkota up on La Crosse Street. Thanks so much for being here tonight. I appreciate the conversation, definitely. Terry Joe, can you tell us about how has this conference programming evolved over the years and why? I know we touched on it a little bit before, but...
Yeah, we discussed the needs. As the needs change, the conference changes. But I might go back to when Maurice started 39 years ago. He was saying that the biggest need as far as classroom management at that time was whether or not a child was chewing gum. That's what you had to deal with. Now, classroom management looks really a whole lot different than it did then. And so we try to provide a lot of training for that particular area because that seems to be a strong need. Mm-hmm. But also education has changed so much just since I've been involved with the conference about 25 years. Mm-hmm. the different methods of teaching writing, for instance, is kind of in on the back burner, if it even exists. And computers have kind of taken over. So as the technology changes, then our conference also changes, and the needs for that change. And the whole child, we now went from classroom education, and our focus being on classroom education, we have kind of evolved a little bit to dealing with the whole child and the needs of the child, the trauma that they experience, the drug and alcohol that they're exposed to.
When you talk about whole child, are you talking about like the home life and the social life?
Absolutely.
And all of that then?
All aspects that a child deals with. Mm-hmm. You know, they're exposed to suicide. They're exposed to things that I wasn't exposed to as a child. Mm-hmm. And they have to try to deal with that. And so we need to help them deal with that. In order for them to get a decent education, they have to know how to cope with all that they're involved with nowadays. And we also have human trafficking on our schedule this year. Mm-hmm. We're going to be talking about that at the conference. And we have school security this year at our conference. We have the ALICE training.
What is ALICE training exactly?
ALICE training is training for schools to know what to do in case a gunman comes in and takes over the school. How are the teachers supposed to react when they catch wind of the fact that there's a gunman in the school? How they protect students, protect themselves. And it's for the whole school, not just the security guards. It's for teachers and administrators to know what they're supposed to do.
It's a shame that we have to have that type of education and that type of training for educators and administrators and students. It really
but
is.
But very necessary.
Very too. Necessary. And it has to be a genuine fear from a student as well that somebody possibly can come in and do these horrible things. Yeah, it just amazes me. Maurice, due to social needs, what are the most important issues presented during, I know we touched on them a little bit, but what other issues are we going to be presenting at the conference then?
Well, to take a look at who is it important to is, I guess, the administrators, the people in the finance department think that the number one issue all the time is finances. Mm-hmm. You know, where do we generate more money, et cetera. So there's different kinds of needs in a conference, in a school, and a conference. You know, the thing of, as Terry had touched on briefly, the suicide prevention. Mm-hmm. That is, suicide and drugs in school are sort of, they're not new, but they're different than they used to be. Several years back, it was hardly noticeable for drugs. Mm-hmm. Now it's a whole strand of things that you need to deal when you deal with drugs. Mm-hmm. So we put that, the crucial ones, toward the top, and that'd be suicide prevention, drug and alcohol awareness, and get those people involved, you know, that can do something about it, those people in the community, the law enforcement, the health people. Mm-hmm. And bullying has risen considerably. It's becoming a technology kind of a thing now too, so cyberbullying is an issue. Mm-hmm. So we have to deal with those, and they're in the conference, so you know, people that are interested in it. The newer one, and this has been going on forever, but suddenly they move it up in importance, is human trafficking. Mm-hmm. And this touches everybody's heart, because you might have a relative, you might have a friend, a daughter, a son has vanished. And you know, what are the methods you need to develop in order to help prevent those things?
It really seems like this conference is about the health of the student, the mental, physical, spiritual, emotional health of the student. And the type of training that you're providing at this conference seems like you're really geared towards not only educational aspects, but the health of the student then, as you mentioned, the whole child, yeah.
That's true.
Yes.
Yeah. We're gonna take a break, but when we get back, let's learn a little bit about more who's gonna be presenting at this conference. So we'll be back after a word from our sponsors.
Family services weren't available in this community, there would be a lot of unmet basic needs. Very few organizations do as good a job as Youth and Family Services, getting every ounce of usefulness out of people's time, their dollars that they donate.
Youth and Family Services helps so many kids. It's a great value to the community.
Join me, because together we help kids.
Hi, welcome back to Oyate Today. Once again, our guests tonight are Maurice Twiss and Terry Joe Gibbons of the Lakota Nation Educational Conference happening this week in Rapid City. Thank you so much for being here. And by the way, how can people, is there somewhere online that we can go to and learn more about this conference then?
Yes, there is. Our website, www.lakotanationsconference.com. You can go on there and register online if you choose to do it that way. But also all our flyers, all our information is on there.
All of the presenters, presentations, all that, it's all available online as well.
Yes.
And who is presenting, and why and what are they presenting then? I know we touched on some of them, but what else is being presented?
Well, we have some what I refer to as old timers, and they're people we have back year after year because they're good, and their sessions are full, overflowing out into the hall.
Wow, okay.
Some of those presenters are Ron Gladowski. He's from Wisconsin, and he talks about angry children, dealing with angry children, and identifying troubled children. He has two different presentations he does. Chris Grant, Captain Chris Grant from the Rapid City Detective Office, he's presented for us forever, and he talks about gangs and identifying gang symbols and different things in your classroom and understanding it. And we have Don Bartlett. He's from Wisconsin also, and he talks about, he was a deformed Native American child without parents and in foster care and mistreated, and he had a terrible life. And he talks about that and talks about what he went through. Suicide was an option for him. Mm-hmm. And he's got two sessions. One of them is called Macaroni at Midnight, and you won't leave dry-eyed when you go to that
wow.
session. It's really powerful. And we have Craig Howell from
Dr.
Martin
Craig
from
Howell,
Carnes.
Yep.
Yes,
yep.
Dr. Craig. And he always is a popular one. His humor is so fun to go in his sessions, you know, and he has...
He's got Lakota, a lot of energy, that guy.
Yes, yeah, Lakota really like Lands him. And Identities yeah. is what he's going to talk about this year, and he's so knowledgeable. We have Stephen Rokosep from the South Dakota Public Broadcasting that comes every year, and he usually does presentations on science, and he's just outstanding. But he's going to talk about Native studies this year.
Oh, wow. Cool.
And he's really good. And, of course, Roger Bordeaux and Terry Albers do our school board training each year. But we have some new presenters this year. And we have Holly Strand. She's doing the human trafficking. And she's from the state and come highly recommended. We have Lauren Pierce. She's from the SDSU. And she's going to be talking about bringing back Native games, which I'm really excited about that. Yeah. Robin Gillespie from here at Rapid City Schools is going to be doing school improvement, which is a big thing in all the schools now, the activities you do and the rules that you have to follow. So she's going to be presenting on that. And then Sarah Pierce, also from Rapid City, is going to be helping with several different presentations.
She's the manager of the Indian Education.
Yes, she is.
Awesome. Well, let's, you know, who's all invited to this? You've been a part of this program for 39 years now. Who do you, we talked about it earlier, but who would you like to invite to this? This is an opportunity to kind of reach out to our community in Rapid City here in the surrounding area, so.
Essentially, I think that we look strongly toward the Native communities located in various reservations. You know, we go to Cheyenne, Eagle Butte, or to Rosebud, to Pine Ridge, or to Flandreau, to North Dakota, and some things in some places in Wyoming. But anybody that needs some knowledge about current happenings and different things should be invited. The parents are so important. The parents are really, it's really great to see a parent that goes through the processes of this training and walks out with their head high in the air, you know, talking about parenting skills. So we like that. Mm-hmm. You know, and some students show up and actually anybody that wants could participate. So that.
Now I understand the conference is going to have a lot of vendors and we're in the Christmas season here and you personally, both of you would like to invite general public to come up and see some of these vendors. What's some of the work that's going to be available?
Well, we have a lot of Native jewelry. We have blankets. We have crafts, a lot of crafts. We just have about anything you'd want. We have dream catchers. We have not just Native crafts either. We have centerpieces. We have, and it's all, some of it, I should say about half of it is focused on Christmas. But the rest of it is just a good way to do your Christmas shopping.
Sure.
And have something unique that's handmade.
Sure. And general public can just come up and
absolutely.
And,
they just
check out the vendors.
In the Rushmore room at Ramcota, the big large room that's west of Minerva's.
Yep, and that's this week on December 12th, 13th, 14th, and 15th.
Yes, it is.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for being here, Maurice. Terry Jo,
thank
you. It was
you,
an awesome
thank
discussion,
you.
And we really appreciate you coming on our program. So I would like to thank Prairie Edge for hosting our show tonight. I want to thank our producers, our sponsors, of course, our guests. And I want to thank you for making Oyate Today a part of your night.
You've been watching Oyate Today, brought to you by Security First Bank. Oh.